Yeah, give me the words and I got the flow. See, I don't gotta write, I got the Holy Ghost. Yeah, that's called a ghost writer. Jeremiah 5 and 14, that's so fire. Isaiah 14 and when I retire, out of captivity, I broke the iron. Who that is coming out of Mount Zion? Woolly head, looking like a lion.
1,000 men marching with no drums on, no trombone, just boots on. Use our voices screaming out, take care of your homes, take care of your wives, take care of your own.
Now we standing out here in the valley of the bones. This place called America, this is not your home. This is like a tomb, place where you died at. Now I resurrected, trying to bring the 12 tribes back.
I came on a slave ship and
I ain't even like that.
Put my neck in the rope and I couldn't even fight back.
Welcome to Four Corners News.
That's right, where the truth speaks. I am Captain Zakar, to my left.
Captain Severus.
And to his left.
Officer Daniel.
And to his left.
Officer Azaniah.
And to his left.
Officer Pagiel.
And we make up Four Corners News.
That brother got the voice of God over there, buddy.
The voice of many waters. All praise to the Most High. Welcome to another news show of the Four Corners News, where we bring you news from all over the earth, and we apply it with the Bible, letting you know that the Bible is a true book.
That's right. Right.
So let's get into the hot news of the week. We got a lot going on across the world, so let's get into it, bring it to the people. Hot news.
Three children kidnapped by car crash victim. Their dad stopped to help.
That's crazy would stop to help somebody and your daggone kids get kidnapped by the person you helping. Wow. That's the times we've come to in these days, man. That's how bad it is out here between each other. Let's read it.
Three children are safe after they were kidnapped by a car crash victim that their father pulled over to help.
Now you see why people don't help nobody no more.
There you go.
You just keep on walking, mind your own damn business, because it could be a daggone setup.
There you go. That's what they're using now.
Yeah.
Most kidnappers are using that tactic. Yeah. They'll hit you from behind.
Yeah.
And the next thing you know, you're getting out trying to check your car. They're kidnapping.
Yep. You're right. You're right. Let's read the rest of that.
I stopped to help and I almost lost everything. The man identified only by his first name, Brian, told Today affiliate Action News 5.
He don't even want to give his damn last name. It's crazy out there. Go ahead.
We have to stay closer because everything can be gone in the blink of an eye.
You're right, man. The Bible talks about that you can get caught in a net and no man knoweth his time. So anything can happen, man. You always got to stay prayed up.
There you go.
Stay prayed up in case anything happens, because it's crazy out here in the world. Also in the hot news, man, the Black Lives Matter is out here doing their thing again like they always do.
They at it again,
They at it again. Let's see what Black Lives Matter is doing in the hot news today.
Black Lives Matter executive accused of siphoning $10 million from Black Lives Matter donors suit
Ain't
says.
This about the damn fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth time that they done been accused? I'm going to say accused because everyone's innocent until proven
allegedly
guilty with the white man.
And Babylon the Great.
Right, Babylon the Great. But this is about the fifth person from Black Lives Matter that has been accused of stealing money from the people.
Yeah.
Right.
Let's read that.
Mr. Bowers and the GNF Leadership Council agreed to execute the transition plan.
That sounds like a gang. Go ahead.
Set forth by Ms. Cullors, the suit said.
Uh-huh.
However, Mr. Bowers, who made $2,167,894 from GNF in
less... Stop right there, though. Check this out. Wow. He made $2 million in 8 months. When the last time y'all saw Black Lives Matter on the street?
Not one.
When the last time y'all saw them do anything, how the hell you make $2 million from that? Right.
Cap, you only see them when it profits them.
Yeah.
When the money is there, they there.
Yeah. So you mean to tell me that that Black Lives Matter profits off of black death?
There you go.
Cap, I think
just like the white man.
I think it's the reverse. When the money low, then that's when they hit the spot.
They got to re-up.
Good point. Groundwork. The street work was the groundwork once they got the endorsements.
Yeah.
And they got that logo pushed on everything.
Yeah, you're right. Exactly right.
NBA.
Yep. That's why the Most High says, you got to know who your money's going to.
Right.
You can't give it to anybody because they can be setting you up. It could be a scam. Right. It could be whatever, man. Right. And you be That's out here right. flat broke and still no change come from where you done invested your money. Still no damn change come from that. That's why God says you got to be careful.
Not
with
even
this
a
stuff.
March. Not even a. Have you ever seen a commercial?
No.
Wait, no way.
I never seen a commercial.
I never seen a black line.
No laws changed.
Man,
none of that stuff, man. So you got to watch where your money go, because it's proof in the pudding, man. It's about the fifth person for Black Lives Matter that done siphoned the damn money from all of y'all that gave the donations, but y'all won't give the Israelites a damn red penny,
right.
a red Woo. Cent. Man, you know that by man. It's a little.
Go ahead, Cappy.
Go
ahead.
Off.
Go play. We got the violin ready to go.
Nah, I ain't gonna do it, man. I ain't gonna do it, man. Hey, also in the hot news, man, Esau showing his true colors once again. Mm. In the army this time, he's doing what he do best. But this time, Esau caught him. Somebody snitched on him. Let's see what's going on in the hot news with the army.
Extremist who said he joined army to kill. Black people discharged.
And don't be shocked by this. It's a lot of folk. Esau. Oh, yeah. Esau folk. I'm calling them mountain people. Mountain people that are in the army that got this thought, but they're not as crazy enough to get caught.
Because
if you get caught, you get that dishonorable discharge. Right. No benefits. Right. And then you're out here to fend for yourself. Bumming change, like we see a lot of people holding signs, veteran.
Right, with the army fatigue, with holes in it and everything.
Yeah.
You know what happens after they transition out of the army?
What's that?
They go into the police force.
Yeah. Damn, that's exactly where he's going. Exactly where he's going. Let's read some more on that mountain people that was trying to kill black people in the army.
Killian McKeith Ryan, 21. Is facing federal charges for lying on an official form. Mm-hmm. The Department of Justice is prosecuting a self-identifying white supremacist former soldier who engaged in violent and racist online communications after he lied on an official form, according to court documents related to a federal investigation.
That's the only reason they mad, and because he lied on the document and come straight out and say it.
Right.
Go ahead, read on it that.
While 21-year-old Killian McKeith Ryan's criminal charges are unrelated to his online activity, federal prosecutors detailed in their complaint much of what they found during their probe. They found messages sent through Instagram.
Through Instagram.
Which explicitly stated Ryan's intent to use his combat training to kill black people. Mm. According to Rolling Stone.
Wow.
Man, that sounds like the Buffalo shooting guy.
There you go.
Yeah. Same thing.
Exactly.
So he went there just to get the military training. So when it does go down, I got the skill set to kill
him. That's it. Get trained up and go out there at the rifle range, get your shooting straight, and then go and shoot up a daggone grocery store. I bet that's what a lot of them do, man. You check the history on them, man. That's why I never trust your enemy.
Never.
Stay the hell away from them. Right. Mind your business.
That's right.
And don't join the military.
That's right.
Come on, y'all.
If
wake
we
up.
We get close to the damn end and you want to go and fight? Right? You want to go and fight Christ?
Are you serious?
What? You crazy. Because you know what? He's going to kill your ass, too. If you out there, your ass is done. If you in the Valley of Megiddo, in the Valley of Decision, your ass is done.
Yeah.
Christ show up at World War III, man. Unbelievable. In the hot news, man, Jackson, man, a person posted the a picture of what their water was like coming out of their tub in Jackson. Let's see that in the hot news, man, what that water actually looked like, man. It's disgusting, man. Let's pull it up for him. Look at that.
Damn.
That's tar.
That's shea.
That's
manure.
That's manure, man.
Yeah.
And mind you, Jackson is a 82% or 92%, one of them 2% black. And that's what the water looked like.
That don't even look like sewage water, guys.
Yeah. Boy, no way,
it don't.
Worse than sewage
water. You're right. That stuff won't look like that in damn Utah, Montana,
absolutely not.
Wyoming, Nebraska. But in Jackson, black ass Mississippi,
right.
Oh, it looks like that. That's what it looks like, man. So send up the prayers for our brothers and sisters that's out there
in Jackson, Mississippi, that's fighting that battle of Esau being the devil that he is, man. So, if you want to send donations there, just reach out to us on This Week in Israel
right.
12@gmail.com, and we'll point you in the right direction
right.
of how to send donations to them. All right.
Make sure you label it too.
Yeah.
What
yeah.
it's for Jackson, Mississippi. Yeah.
When you get it to them, right. just email us thisweekinisrael12@gmail.com, right. and we'll point you in the right direction. Also, that's in the right. hot news, the Pope out here showing who he is, man, being a crook. Let's show him what the Pope is out here doing and telling everybody Catholicism is a cult. Hear me when I say Catholicism is a cult. Let's read that.
Pope Francis instructs Vatican entities to move all funds to Vatican Bank by September 30th.
That's damn. A cult. When they control your money and right. tell you where to put it. Now, check this out. When in Acts, when they was bringing the money to the apostles, they said a willing heart.
Right.
Everyone that had a willing heart brought the money. They didn't force, they didn't beat nobody over there. No. They didn't put out no air, man. Everybody got to bring the money and lay it at the disciples' feet. That wasn't the order. No. It was of a willing heart, but not this cult called Catholicism. Mm. What they do, they say, hey, September 30th, we want all the money in here right now, that right? Was. So I can touch that money and take out what I need to. Let's see what they talk about today at the Vatican, because it's crazy. You're going to be shocked how much money they got. Let's see that.
In his August 23rd rescript, Pope Francis said Article 219, Paragraph 3 of Praedicate Evangelium.
Man, that brother's good. Go ahead.
Must be interpreted to mean that the activity of asset manager and custodian of the movable patrimony of the Holy See and of the institutions connected with the Holy See is the exclusive responsibility of the Institute for Works of Religion.
Basically, that means it must be interpreted. This is what I want you to
right,
tell them.
Right.
Put that money in the bank, and this is what you wanted to tell them, but tell them I'm strong-arming this damn money. That's what it means. But I want you to put it in here. This is the technicality of the shit, because you know we got our stuff on paper. But, a.k.a., bring your money here.
Hey,
that's
Cap,
what that means.
Cap, now I'm seeing why the pastor's got the three P's. Pastor, pimp, and what is I don't know,
prophet.
Not hell.
Hell no.
Prophet. Like, not
oh, you
prophet.
Mean the other prophet.
Yeah.
Not for game.
No, no, that's too close.
P-R-O-F-I-T. Yeah. Okay.
Because that right there, that's pimp moves right there.
Yeah, that's straight pimp
bring
move.
Bring me my money.
That's what it is. That's a pimp.
Bring me my money.
Exactly. Yeah, remember, all those churches do carry the logo.
Yeah.
That crucifixion, or demonic crucifixion that they got.
Yeah.
That's their logo.
Yeah, yeah. That's it right there.
Bring me my money. Bring me my royalties.
Bring me my money. Yeah. Also in the hot news, one more former slave master, slave money person just passed away in the news, and sorry, we don't give a damn,
right?
let's pull it up and see what happened over there in England across the waters.
Queen Elizabeth II has died.
Yep, Elizabeth is gone, y'all. Yep, she
the
gone.
Queen is dead,
yep, she gone.
Did y'all hear Officer Joshua's somber voice when he read that?
Yeah, Wolverhampton.
Yeah.
Oh, she's gone. Let's read that. Let's
died,
read that,
y'all.
Read that, officer.
Hold it
Come
down.
Come on now, dog.
Queen Elizabeth II, the UK's longest serving monarch, has died at Balmoral, age 96, after reigning for 70 years.
This is the point I want you to pay attention to in the hot news. Read that.
She died peacefully on Thursday afternoon at her Scottish estate, where she had spent much of the summer.
At her what? Scottish estate. That's slave money right there.
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah.
You
know where she spent most of her summer. Y'all know Britain gets cold. It got winters.
Right.
She ain't never worked no damn job in her life.
Yeah.
Where'd she get that money from? She got it from Jamaica.
Yes.
She got that stuff from Montego, from Trinidad. From the islands. That's where that summer house and that Scottish damn resort or estate come from. That's slave money.
That's why a lot of our brothers over there, they got to get a British passport.
Right.
Damn.
You know what I'm saying? Yep.
Crazy. You know the crazy part about it? Before she died, she visited all the places her ancestor conquered.
Oh, yep.
So before her life went, she said, I done did
this. I'm going to see the slaves one more again. I want to see them one more time. That was slave money where she had a Scottish estate.
Hey, is her face on any other coins? Or
the money. It was.
It is?
Yeah. Some of the money.
Wait a minute.
Yeah. Yeah, so you know, and guess what? She knew that she was great gold. Mm-hmm. She tried to make amends. Remember, they just gave one of the islands their quote unquote independence or something Barbados. Like that, Barbados or somebody. Mm-hmm. She's no longer the ruling authority mm-hmm. over Barbados, right. And then she passed away. She think it's gonna make her good with God. Right. Hell no!
I'll give one island back. It's the same thing that I think was it Alexander who tried to do that? He said after he terrorized the Jews,
right?
He said, "Hey, can you please ask God for forgiveness?"
Everything was Antiochus.
Antiochus
jacked up.
Yeah,
jacked him up.
Yeah.
And next thing you know, he went on. Please forgive the Jews. Please forgive me.
Don't mind.
Pray
but
for
that
me.
Article is written in a deceitful way because it should say how she terrorized the people.
Right. Yeah. But you know, they ain't going to say that. No. It's Esau. He's all about lies, man. Yeah. He wants to make himself God, the good guy, the enemy from all the problems that he called.
Right.
He wants to be the hero of the story. Well, she's gone. Ain't nobody over here sad at all.
We just going to wait for
you
the next
You Benjamites,
one.
You better stay in the spirit. That's all
right. Spirit.
Club was that at?
That was admit that a lot of people don't even realize that.
I've called her. She hasn't responded. I've called her more than a few times.
But the Zulu Nation, I'm like, what the hell is this? I know nobody know what I'm talking about. You'll leave me on the island by myself. I don't know what the hell Bishop's talking about. That's what y'all do. Didn't have to class. Yeah, I knew what you were talking about. I just didn't want to be caught out there. The hell is this? Get on my damn nerves.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I have an important message about your leaders in the Christian church. Your bishops, pastors, reverends, and ministers are all lying to you and leading you straight to damnation. The truth is, you so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans are the biblical Israelites, according to Deuteronomy chapter 28. Jesus Christ is a black man with white wool hair, according to Revelation chapter 1. Verses 14 and 15. We as the Israelites must keep the commandments in the faith of Christ to receive salvation, as it is written in Revelation chapter 14, verse 12. I've challenged and debated Christian authorities all over the world on these issues. Not one of them has been able to negate this truth. Your pastors have led you astray, worshiping pagan holidays and false gods, just as in the days of old. So join us on our mission to restore the true nation of Israel before the decree goes forth. The work is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Visit our website at israelunite.org or call us at 855-484-4842 to learn more and visit our schools. Shalom.